Here is a quick overview of tethering over Wi-Fi between the NX500 camera and the iPad. In order to activate the camera wireless network, press the mobile button on its top. The camera screen will display four wireless tasks it can perform. The remote viewfinder is second from the top. The camera will show the name of its Wi-Fi network. Select this network ID on the iPad Wi-Fi settings menu. But don't forget to install the Samsung Camera Manager app prior to that. The first time you pair a mobile device to the camera, confirm its registration on the camera. As you can see afterwards, the device would pair more or less automatically. The connection should be even faster with a near-field communication, but there is no NFC on my iPad. The remote viewfinder initially goes to the camera automatic mode, independently of which mode is selected on the camera dial. Let's switch camera to the manual mode that offers most of the control of the camera. The camera settings, or so-called smart panel, has a number of options and settings available. Note that the selected options will remain on the camera after the connection with the mobile device has ended. However, there is no possibility to save the camera settings with the remote viewfinder. Besides, not all of the camera features are supported. For instance, there are no custom or color temperature white balance. The light metering can be switched to a multi-zone, center-weighted and the spot modes. There is a continuous multi-expansion function, as well as exposure delays, but no brackets shooting among the drive settings. The raw image format appears to be also missing. Only photos and JPEG are remotely recorded. Video resolution up to Full HD is supported, but there are no 4K UHD video mode. When there is a good Wi-Fi connection, there is a relatively quick update rate of a live view screen window. There is a possibility basically to record the photo. Okay. And here you have an option for video. We just started to record. For the power zoom lenses, the zoom and the focus can be adjusted both on the camera lens and on the touch screen of a mobile device. Yeah, we'll try. Okay. It's funny, but I'm never sure which operation the lens ring would perform, focusing and zooming. Here is we do zooming. Another time it was focusing. And here you can see a part of a remotely recorded video from the NX500. A bit of focus pulling and a zoom out and zoom in. And here you are. Not bad. And here is remote zooming with an iPad. As you can see, there is some delay or lag on the live view when this mode of zooming is chosen. Nonetheless, it's a great option to have, and I'm pretty happy with the result. Let's quickly glance also on other network operations which are available over wireless network. The mobile link, for example, allows to copy photos from the camera to a mobile device. Here you can see a few of the photos from the camera displayed. The selection and uploading of a single image of a whole set is relatively straightforward. Well, here is one 6 megabyte photo. Relatively quick. I think the most of the delay is due to recording on the iPad. Upon completion, the menu would offer an option to share the photos via email, the Facebook or a cloud service. I guess there should be a possibility to add other ways to share images. In fact, it is also possible to directly email photos from a camera over Wi-Fi, which is actually all I really like a lot. The ProSuggest Market is another interesting feature, allowing to download various custom settings to a mobile device and share them with the camera. However, it requires an additional 3G LTE network, which my iPad doesn't support. And the Bluetooth connection between an NX500 and iOS device is not supported. Talking about restriction, a mobile device can tether with only one device at a time and only one camera at a time, and the maximum distance between the camera and the mobile device cannot be more than 7 meters. Nonetheless, the wireless capabilities of the camera are very promising, and I really enjoy using it.